Hello students, in last lecture we have seen a meaning of a number having index in rational form. So that point is here a number A having index m upon n, that is a rational form of index. So what is the meaning of this number? We have seen in last lecture. In this index m upon n, the m which is a numerator, it shows the value of power, and n which is a denominator shows the value of root. This number has a two meaning which are given here. See, first and second. So what is the meaning of this number? So this number has a two meaning, that is, first one is a raised to m raised to 1 upon n. So what it means, that is 1 upon n. So n shows the root. So nth root of nth power of a. So this is the meaning of first number. Then another meaning, that is a raised to 1 upon n raised to m. It means m, that is the power, m shows the value of power. So mth power of nth root of number a. See, mth power of nth root of a. See, this number has two meaning. While writing this, you just alter the index values. See here, m inside and 1 upon n outside the bracket. While writing another meaning, you just alter the this place of values, that is outside 1 upon n you have to take inside the bracket, and m which is inside you have to take it outside. So this number has a two meaning, and these are their meaning. So in this way, this point we have studied in last lecture. Now today on this we have given a practice set 3.2. So from that practice set we have to solve some example here. See, first example. So in this practice set you have to write the meaning of given number having index in m upon n form or rational form of index. So you have to just write the meanings of this given number. Already we have seen here, that is each number has a two meaning, and we have to write these two meaning here. So first one is 225 raised to 3 upon 2. See here, index is 3 upon 2. So this 3 upon 2 index, in which 3 which is numerator, it shows the value of power, and 2 is on denominator side which shows the value of root. So while writing this meaning, you must remember these values of power and roots. So first one is, we have to write the two meanings of this value. So first one is power of root. So we have to write first power and then root. So in this example, value of power, what is value of power? That is 3. So power, value of power is 3. So you have to write here cube of root. So value of root is 2. So cube of second root or square root, you may also write here square root of given number, that is 225. So this is the first meaning. See, this value shows value of power, and this shows value of root. So first one is cube of second root or square root of given number, that is 225. This is the first meaning. Now second meaning, In second meaning, you have to write the root value first and then power value. So see, root value of root is 2. So square root or second root, square root of power, value of power is 3, square root of cube, because the value of power is 3. So we have to write here cube. So square root of cube of given number, that is 225. So this is the two meanings of this given number. In this way you have to solve examples. We see another example, second example, 45 raised to 4 upon 5. See, in this example the value of index is 4 upon 5. So you know that numerator value shows the value of power and denominator value shows value of root. Now you have to write the meanings. You have to write the meaning of this number. So first one is power of root. So here is a fourth power. So you have to write here fourth power. You have to write fourth power of root. Value of root is 5. So fourth power of fifth root of number, that is 45. So this is the first meaning of number. Now second one, while writing this you must write first value of root and then value of power. So here value of root is 5. So fifth root of power, that is 4. Fifth root of fourth power of given number, that is 45. So in this way we have to solve given examples in the practice set 3.2. Hello friends, in last we have started the practice set 3.2. First question we have seen. Now second question we have to solve today. In first question we have seen that if a number is given, you have to write their meaning in two form. As we know that rational form of indices, that is a raised to m upon n. In this m upon n, it is a rational form of indices in which first number, that is a numerator m, which shows the value of power, and denominator, that is n, which shows the value of root. So with the help of this we already solved the first question. Now second question, see, write the following number in the form of rational indices. So second question we have to solve here. In this we have given of number format and we have to write the rational indices. So first example is square root of fifth power of 121. So in this example given number is 121. See, given number is 121 and we have to write the rational indices, that is m upon n form of indices. So in this example square root, that is root value is, square means 2, so root value, that is denominator side, which is 2. Square root of fifth power, so value of power, that is m, which is 5. So in this way we have to write this rational indices. So meaning of this square root of 5th power of 121. So in this way we can write the rational indices. Now second example, cube of 4th root of number, that is 324. So in this we have given a number 324. Now we have to write the rational indices of this number. So while writing this, we must know value of root and value of power. So these values are important. In this example, see, cube of, that is, cube means third power. So value of power is 3 upon root value, 4th root. So here the value of root is 4. So 3 upon 4. This is the rational index of this number. So this is our second example, cube of 4th root of 324. Similarly, next example, 5th root of square of 264. So in this example, what is the number? 264, right? 264. And now we have to write a rational indices. So in this example, what is the value of power and what is the value of root? See here, 5th root, that is value of root, that is denominator, which is a 5, and 5th root of square means second power, that is its value is 2. So 264 raised to 2 upon 5. So this is the rational indices form. Now next one is fourth example, cube of 3. So in this example, cube means 3. We know that cube means third power, or cube, it indicates the value 3 times, or 3, it shows the value 3. So in this example, the given number is 3, and now we have to write the value of power and root. So here, cube of, that is third power, so we have to write the value of m as a 3, and cube of cube root, it means value is 3, root value is also 3. So you have to write this. So cube of cube root of 3. So this form of example we have to solve in this way, as given here. So while solving this type of example, you must know the value of power as well as value of root. So in this way we have to solve here, practice set 3.2. Now you have a homework, that is, you have to solve this practice set 3.2 in your notebook. So next point, you have to solve practice set 3.2 also. In last lecture I have told that you have to solve the practice set 3.1 in your notebook. So you have to solve this practice sets in your homework, in your notebook. Now next point is a recall. So next point given as a let's recall, that is, this point is already you have learned in last standard. So what is given here? So 4 into 4, that is 4 square, its value is 16. Also minus 4 into minus 4, that is also 16. So in this we have seen that the square root of 16, see, square root of the 16 is 4, that is plus 4 as well as minus 4. So every positive number, see, so every positive number has two square roots. Every positive number has two square roots, that is positive and negative. In this example, we have seen here. So positive root of 16, which is shown by positive root of 16. In this way, we have shown it. And negative root of 16, we have shown by this, in this way. So positive root of 16, that is plus 4. And negative root of 16, that is minus 4. So every positive number has a two square roots. That is 16, this number has a two square root, that is plus 4 and minus 4. Same way, root 25, this value also have two square roots, that is plus 5 and minus 5. That is, every positive number has a two square roots, positive and negative. Now next, square root of 0, see, square root of 0 is 0, that is square root of 0. In the form of radical sign, we have to write here square root of 0, or in index form we have to write 0 raised to 1/2. So the square root of 0 is 0. So you have to remember these two points. Now next one is, now next point, cube and cube root. Next point is cube and cube roots, ghana ani ghanamool. Next point, cube and cube root. You already know what is a cube. You have know that what is the concept of cube. So first one is cube and cube root. Cube and cube roots. So ghana ani ghanamool. Ata ha point aplyala pude baghaycha ahe. First, what is the concept of cube? Cube. Cube. So cube, what is the concept of cube? If a number, suppose we have find the cube of 4, so 4 raised to 3, cube means third power, so 4 raised to 3, that is 4 into 4 into 4. So in cube, if a number write 3 times, see here, if a number write 3 times and multiplied, then the product is called as a cube of that number. So here the cube of 4 is 64. We have write 3 times this number and multiplied, and then the product, that is 64, which is a cube of this given number, that is 4. So this is the concept of cube. So in this way we have to find the cube of any number. Now next one, you have to find the cube of 5, that is 5 into 5 into 5, that is 125. Now next one is, suppose you have given a value minus 6. See, you have to find the cube of minus 6. That is, you have to multiply this number 3 times, that is minus 6 into minus 6 into minus 6. So the multiplication is 216 with negative sign. So you have to remember that if number is positive, its cube is also positive, and if given number is negative, then its cube is also negative. So if we have to find if we have to find the cube, if we have to find the cube of negative number, that is cube of 3 minus 3. So what is the cube of this minus 3? You have to multiply it 3 times. Given number is negative, so the cube is also negative. Now next, you have to find the cube of this minus 2 upon 5. So now given number is minus 2 upon 5. You have to find the cube. So you have to multiply this number 3 times. Hence number is negative, so the cube is also negative. Now you multiply numerator values and multiply the denominator values. So the answer is minus 8 upon 125. So from that we have to conclude that if the given number is positive, its cube is positive, and if the given number is negative, its cube is also negative. Now next one is we have to find the cube. We have to find the cube of number which is in decimal fraction form. So next point is we have to find the cube of number which is in decimal form. So example is 0.02. We have to find the cube of this number, that is 0.02. So to find the cube of this type of number, that is decimal fraction numbers, to solve this example, first we have to observe the number of decimal places in the number. In this given number decimal places, there are 2 decimal places. So decimal places are 2 in this example. Decimal places 2. While solving this type of example, first you have to observe the number of decimal places. In this there are 2 decimal places. So from this number we have confirmed that how many decimal places in the cube of this given number. So to find that decimal places, you have to multiply this number, that is decimal places in given number, with 3. So the multiplication is 6. So while solving this example, number of decimal places are 6. म्हणजे ह्या पद्धतीने आपण हे उदाहरण सोडवताना डेसिमल प्लेसेस किती आहे हे सर्वप्रथम बघायचे आहे. यामध्ये बघा डेसिमल प्लेसेस किती, 1 आणि 2. म्हणून डेसिमल प्लेसेस लिहिले आपण 2, आणि त्याच्या नंतर ह्या नंबरवरून आपल्याला जे उत्तर येणार आहे, म्हणजे जो क्यूब येणार आहे, त्या क्यूबमध्ये किती डेसिमल प्लेसेस असतील तर ते आपल्याला काढता येतं. मग त्यासाठी ह्या 2 ला आपण 3 ने काय करायचं, मल्टिप्लाय करायचं आहे. म्हणजे जो कोणताही नंबर या ठिकाणी असेल, सपोज डेसिमल प्लेसेस 1 असेल तर त्या 1 ला आपण 3 ने मल्टिप्लाय करू. सपोज डेसिमल प्लेसेस 3 असेल तर त्या 3 ला पण आपण 3 ने काय करू, मल्टिप्लाय करू. म्हणजे हे जे मल्टिप्लिकेशन येणार आहे, हे मल्टिप्लिकेशन म्हणजेच काय, नंबर ऑफ डेसिमल प्लेसेस इन द क्यूब ऑफ दिस नंबर. म्हणजे ज्यावेळेस आपण याचा क्यूब करू त्यावेळेस त्या उत्तरामध्ये डेसिमल प्लेसेस किती असतील, 6 असतील. ठीक आहे, बघूया आपण आता. सो वी हॅव टू फाइंड द क्यूब ऑफ दिस नंबर, दॅट इज 0.02. सो यू हॅव टू मल्टिप्लाय दिस नंबर इटसेल्फ 3 टाइम्स. सो यू हॅव टू मल्टिप्लाय दिस नंबर 3 टाइम्स. 0.02 into 0.02. Then First, you have to do a cube of given number. In this number is 2, so cube of 2 is 8. Now we know that decimal places are 6. So after writing the cube, you have to write the zeros on left side up to 6 places. So this is our first number, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and give the decimal point, and here 0. So this is our answer. See, in this cube there are 6 decimal places. So in the cube of this number there are 6 decimal places, and with the help of this we can find out the number of decimal places in the cube of given number.